Hello friends, welcome to Sri Ananta tutorial. I can assure you that you will get a very good study material on our channel without wasting your precious time. If you find it useful, don't forget to subscribe our channel. In this video, I am going to explain you how the min terms are represented in K-map. As we have already learned that any function, say if there is a function f of variable 3 variable ABC, can be represented in min term notation like sigma m, say 0, 1, 4, 5, 7 or in this way, or it can also be represented as f is equal to m0 plus m1 plus m4 plus m5 m7. So, if there is any Boolean function f which is represented in min terms notation like this, or if there is any other function of two variable and it is represented as like this, f two variable function f is equal to sigma m 0 1 3 or m 0 plus m 1 plus m 3. In a similar way, if there is any other function of four variable a b c d and it is represented as sigma m 0 1 say 3 9 12 14, 15, or M0 plus M1, M3, M9, M12, M14, M15. Means if any Boolean function is represented in min terms notation, or you can say in SOP form, then how it will be represented in K-map. As we have seen in our previous lecture that two variable K-map will have four division in this way. Three variable K-map will have eight division. In this manner, similarly, four variable K-map will have 16 divisions. Yes, this is two variable, this is three variable K-map, two variable K-map, and this is four variable K-map. So, this is two variable K-map, this is three variable K-map, and this is four variable K-map. Now, as we have seen that if we write variables, so here it will be A bar A and b bar b. If there is three variable, then it will be a bar a, this is b bar c bar, b bar c, b c, b c bar. And if this is four variable KMF, then we may write four variable in this manner: a bar b bar, a bar b, AB, AB bar and C bar D bar, C bar D, CD, CD bar. So this is the representation of variables in KMap. But our objective is, if the Boolean function is not given in terms of variable, it is given in terms of min terms, or you can say if it is given in canonical form, then we have to assign certain number to these division. First we take example of two variable. So now come to this division. If we take this division into consideration, here a bar b bar means 0 0. So 0 0 is 0 in 0 0 in binary is equivalent to 0 in decimal. Now come to this division, here a bar b, a bar b means 0 1, a bar is 0 and b is 1, so this division is 0 1. So we may write it as 1. Now come to this one, this division is a b bar means 1 0. 10 in binary is equivalent to 2 in decimal, so it will be 2. And for this one, this is a b, means a means 1, b is 1. 11 in binary is equivalent to 3 in decimal, so we will assign value 3 for this division. So this is the min term representation for a two variable KMap. Now in what way we will assign the values? For example, if we take this one, a function is given as sigma m 0 1 3. So the term which is written in the Boolean function, that is 0, 1, 3. So we will mark as in those divisions. This is 0, 0 is here. We will mark it as 1. This is 1, this is 1. Then again this term is present, we will mark it as 1. Now 3. So this is the division. For 3, we will also mark this division as 1. So here it completes the Boolean function, the representation, the Boolean function which is represented in minterm form or canonical form can be represented in KMap in this manner. And after marking it 1 in the appropriate divisions, we follow the simplification rules to simplify the function, which I will explain you in the next lecture. Now in the same manner, for 3 variable KMap, if you take that a 3 variable Boolean function is given, FABC is equal to sigma m 0, 1, 4, 5, 7. Or you can say these min terms are present in the Boolean function. So we will mark here. So first we have to assign the values to these division, what we have done for two variable. Now come to for this division. Here A bar, B bar, C bar means 0, 0, 0, and 0, 0, 0 in binary is equivalent to 0 in decimal. Come to the next one. This is A bar, B bar, C means 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 1 is equivalent to 1. Come to the next one. This is 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1 in binary is equivalent to 3 in decimal. And similarly for this one, this is A bar B C bar. A bar B C bar means 0, 1, 0. And 0, 1, 0 in binary is equivalent to 2 in decimal. So in this manner we will assign the values 0, 1, 2, 3. If we adopt the same pattern, then we will have A B bar C bar means 1, 0, 0. So it will be 4, 5. This will be 6 and this is 7. So in this manner we can assign the values for a 3 variable K map if the Boolean function is represented in canonical form or is represented in min term form. Now how one is assigned in this K map? If we take this function, say if you to avoid any type of confusion, we can mark it as F1, F2, F3. So this is F2, this is F1 and this is F3. Now come to the function F1. F1 is a 3 variable function and the representation is given in min term forms in this manner. The terms which are present in the Boolean function, that is 0, 1, 4, 5, 7. So we will mark here 1 in those places. 0, 1, 4, 5, 7. So this Boolean function is represented in K-map in this manner. Right. Same is the criteria what we have followed for 2 variable K-map, for 3 variable K-map. Same is the criteria we follow for 4 variable K maps to assign these values to a particular division. Right? For example, randomly if I pick this division, okay, so this division is ABCD. Here it is AB row wise and column wise it is CD. So ABCD means 1, 1, 1, 1. And we know that 1, 1, 1, 1 in binary is equivalent to 15 in decimal. So we will assign a value 15 here. Take another example for any other division, say, for this division, right? For this division, this is A bar B, C bar D. So A bar B means 0, 1 and 0, 1. So 0, 1, 0, 1 in binary is equivalent to 5 in decimal. So we will assign a value 5 here. So in this manner you can assign the values in 4 variable kmap also. Here we will get 0, then 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and this is 15. The rule is same for assigning any value, for assigning a value to any of the division of a kmap, whether it is a 2 variable kmap, 3 variable kmap, 4 variable kmap, 5 variable kmap, 6 variable kmap. The criteria will remain same. If you want to check it randomly, just pick a division. Say for example, I want to check this division. Here, this is A bar B C D bar. A bar B means 0, 1, 1, 0. So 0, 1, 1, 0 in decimal is 6. That's why 6 is written here. Clear? So, now, if we want to represent this Boolean function into give this Boolean function is given in minterm or canonical form, and we have to represent this function into 4 variable kmap. So the term which are present in the Boolean function, we will mark a 1 at those places, 0, 1, 3, 9, 12, 14, 15, right? So this was all about a Boolean function which is given in min term or canonical form. How we can represent a Boolean function in kmap. I hope that you have clearly understood the representation of a Boolean function in kmap form, and in my future lectures I will explain you the simplification techniques, means how these Boolean function can be simplified. The rules of the simplification I have already told you in my previous lecture. Thank you.
I hope you find this video useful in your study. If it is so, don't forget to give your like and share it with your friends. And do leave your comments down below. Thank you.